奉主耶稣圣名为主作见证。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I bear testimony on behalf of God.
最初修顿教会安排布道会有三处的机会。
And this time, Houston Church has arranged for 3 evangelical services.
今天晚上第一次。
And tonight is our first time.
明天下午第二次。
And tomorrow is the second time.
明天晚上第三次。
And tomorrow evening is the third.
这三处的布道会，我定个主题叫生命的更新。
And for this topics of the evangelical services, I have set the topic as renewing our lives.
那今天晚上先讲其中一部分，就是价值观的改变。
And so tonight I'd like to talk about the first portion, which is changing our values.
你的生命改变以后，你就会有不同的价值观。
Because after our life values, after our lives has been renewed, then we will have a different value system.
在创世二章十六、十七节记载。
And in Genesis chapter 6 verses 16 and 17 it says
神对亚当说伊甸里面的果子你都可以吃
And God told Adam that of all the trees in the Garden of Eden you may eat
就神给人的自由意志你想吃什么就可以吃什么
And this is the free will that God has given to man that whatever you want to eat you may eat
然后他的唯有园中那个分别上的果子你不能吃
And he says the only tree that you may not eat of in this garden is the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
这个表示神给人自由有一个限制。
And so that even in the freedom that God has given us, there is a restriction and limitation.
因为没有限制的自由不是真的自由。
Because a freedom without any limitations is not true freedom.
那变放纵。
It just becomes a way of enjoyment.
好像法律给我们有自由，你要做什么就做什么。
And just like the law, it gives us a freedom that we are allowed to do what we want to do.
但法律这样好像规定你不能做，你做了就是犯法。
But then there are some laws that we must follow that we cannot do it, we cannot go against it, otherwise we have committed a crime.
如果没有法律的限制，天下都大乱。
And if there is no limitations in the law, then the whole world will be in chaos.
公路是属于国家，也属于大家的。
And then these the roads they belong to the whole country.
谁都可以开车。
And everyone can drive on it.
但它有交通规则。
But then there are traffic laws.
假如没有交通规则限制，交通就大乱。
And if there are no traffic laws, then the traffic will be a mess.
一样道理，神给人自由，你要吃什么就吃什么。
And in the same manner, then God gave mankind the freedom to eat whatever they want to eat.
他有限制，不能吃这个分别善的果子。
But then he has commanded that they shall not eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
然后说，神说，你吃的日子必定死。
And then God told them that in the day you eat of it, you shall surely die.
今天吃，今天死，明天吃，明天死。
If you eat it today, you die today. If you eat it tomorrow, you die tomorrow.
后来亚当不听神的话，吃了。
But then Adam did not listen to God, and he ate of this fruit.
但圣经说他没有马上死掉。
But then the Bible says he did not die immediately.
又活了几百岁。
And he lived several hundred years more.
为什么神说你吃的那天必定死，他又能活几百岁呢？
So why is it that even though God said that on the day you shall eat of this fruit, you shall surely die, and yet he still lived several hundred years?
在创世二章七节那边记载。
And in Genesis chapter 2 verse 7 it says,
神用尘土造人以后,
that after God formed man from the dust of the ground,
就给他吹口气成为有灵的活人,
that he breathed into his nostrils so that he became a living being.
这个活人原文的意思叫做活魂。
And then the living being in the original text, it means a living soul.
英文圣经也是这么翻译。
It means, and in the English Bible, it actually says a living being.
表述他的魂有神的生命。
And so this being itself has this God's life.
那就属灵生命。
And this is the spiritual life.
亚当吃了善恶果，虽然身体没有马上死去。
And even though Adam ate of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, his physical body did not immediately die.
但他已经没有属灵生命。
But he did not have spiritual life.
在路加五九章五十九六十节那里说。
And in Luke chapter 9 verses 59 and 60 it says.
耶稣的门徒对耶稣说。
And it says that Jesus spoke to his disciples.
准他先去埋葬父亲才来跟耶稣。
That, and then these, they wanted to go and bury their dead before they came to follow Jesus.
耶稣说任凭死人埋葬他的死人。
And Jesus told them to let the dead bury the dead.
你要跟踪我。
And then you shall follow me.
在人看来观察你的是死人。
And then in, to the human beings, then what we see in the coffin is a dead person.
送葬的是活人。
And the people who are actually attending the memorial service are alive.
行动,
Because they can still move.
但耶稣说他们也是死人。
But then the Bible tells us that they are also dead.
所以耶稣才说任凭死人埋葬他的死人。
And this is why Jesus Christ said to let the dead bury the dead.
虽然那些送葬人会哀哭。
And then so when someone dies, then people will cry.
他肉体是活的。
And their body is still living.
但已经没有属灵生命。
But yet there is no spiritual life.
在马太十六章二十六节记载。
And in Matthew chapter 16 it records.
耶稣说一个人能够赚了全世界赔上他生命有什么用呢
？And he says, "What use is it if a man gains the entire world but loses his life?"
人还能够拿什么东西把失去生命换回来呢
？And what is it that man can use to buy back his life?
一个人要赚全世界不可能。
And for a person to actually to earn his own life is impossible.
人的能力有限。
Because man's limitations. 一生
的生命很短暂。
And their life is very short.
世界的今天财宝是无限。
And the amount of treasures that you can gain on this earth is very limited.
用有限的能力、有限的生命，要赚取全世界无限的财宝是不可能。
And it's impossible to use our limited time on this earth and also our limited abilities to gain the entire world.
但耶稣说，假如有一个人，
But yet Jesus Christ said that if there is such a person,
他有很强的能力。
That they have such great abilities.
他用短暂一生能够赚取全世界。
And in their temporary and short life, they're able to earn the entire world.
假如没有生命，有什么用呢？
And yet, if they do not have life, what use is it?
耶稣所说用全的财宝不能换取的生命，是讲属灵生命。
And when Jesus was talking about the fact that he cannot gain his life with all the treasures in this world, he's talking about the spiritual life.
肉体生命没有那么大的价值。
Because the physical life doesn't have such great value.
那个是属灵的生命。
But rather, it is a spiritual life.
啊，那个生命原文是魂，英文的翻译成魂。
And the spiritual life is a spirit.
就是魂有永生，这样的生命。
It's a soul, and this soul has its eternal life.
它的价值胜过世界的财宝。
And its value is above the value of all the treasures in this world.
我们这一次的主题说，生命更新，就是说要得到那一种属灵的生命。
And this time our theme is a renewal of life, and this is the kind of life that we want to talk about.
它有无限的价值。
That the spiritual life it has an infinite value.
你得到这一种新的生命，你的价值观就完全改变。
And if you were to receive this type of life, then your entire value system would change.
很多人的观念认为地位高最好。
And there are many people with the concept that as long as we have a high status, then it's very good.
得到更高地位就跟人竞争。
And because they want to attain a very high status, then they compete with others.
有人认为有智慧、有知识最好。
And some people think to have knowledge or wisdom is the best.
因为有知识、有智慧不必求人，反而别人求你。
Because if you were to have wisdom and knowledge, then you would not ask of anybody, but rather everyone would be asking of you.
有人认为有钱最好，所以就拼命赚钱。
And then there are others that think that the wealth is the best, and so they continue to do what they can to earn more.
Yeah, 因为有了钱以后想买什么就有什么。
Because if you have money, then you're able to buy whatever you want to buy.
有人认为物质享受最好。
And then some people think that to have a house to live is the best.
因为人生很短暂。
Because life is very short.
现在有钱不享受要等什么时候呢？
And then if we have money, but yet.
但是所罗门告诉我们，这些都是虚空。
But then we have a short life. But then Solomon tells us that all is vanity. That vanity is a vanity.
从那书的一章开始就说，一切都是虚空。
And from the very beginning of Ecclesiastes chapter 1, he tells us that all is vanity.
好，我们现在看几段圣经。
Let's look at a few Bible verses.
传道书的第一章。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 1.
十二节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 1, verse 12.
传道书第一章十二节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 1.
我传道者在耶路撒冷做过以色列的王。十三节。
Chapter 1, verse 12, 13.
我专心用智慧寻求查究天下所做一切事。乃是神教授人所经历的是极重的劳苦啊！所罗门他说他做过王
and Solomon he says that he is the king
做王是全国地位最高的
and the king is the highest status in the entire kingdom
但是他说他用他智慧去思考
and yet he says that he has used his wisdom to seek
用他的 人生去经历。
And then also to use his life to experience.
用眼睛去观察。
And he used his eyes to see.
才发现神给人所经历的是极重劳苦。
But what he found is that this task that God has given to man is burdensome.
这个告诉我们地位不高不是享受。
And so this tells us that to have high status is not an enjoyment.
地位告诉一种很大的精神负担。
But rather to have high status is a very a taxing thing on your energy. 好像
一个家庭里面地位最高是父亲。
And just like in the family, the highest unit is the father.
他说一家的主人。
Because he is the master of the house.
但责任最终也是这个父亲。
But then the one with the most responsibilities is also this father.
这个家要兴旺或者衰微。
And whether or not this house is going to prosper or fail.
这个全家人活得很幸福或者活得很痛苦。
And whether or not this family is going to live very blessed or very pitifully.
看他怎么经营。
And it depends on how he handles things.
所以他的责任很重。
And so the father's responsibility is great.
心理负担也是很重。
And it's also a very great responsibility on his heart.
因此地位高不是享受，是一种极大的劳苦。
And so to have a high status is not an enjoyment, but rather it is a burden.
那么求智慧之树有什么结果呢？
And then to ask for wisdom and knowledge, what is the end result?
很多人为了求更丰富的知识。
And there are many people who want to gain more wisdom and knowledge.
为了得到更高的地位，地智慧。
And then they want to gain more knowledge in this world.
他就说，哎，过去留学，读了一个学位。
And then they might go overseas to go and study and get a degree.
但所罗门说这个不能得到什么福气。
But yet Solomon says that this is not a blessing.
啊，我们看传道书第一章。
Let's turn back to Ecclesiastes chapter 1.
十八节。
Verse 18.
传道书的第一章十八节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 18.
因为多有智慧就多有愁烦，加增知数的就加增忧伤。啊，这里说智慧多，知识增加，忧伤愁烦就增加。
And here it tells us that in much wisdom is much grief, and he who increases knowledge increases sorrow.
因为有智慧、有知识人，他对很多问题的看法很深刻。
Because someone who has wisdom and knowledge, then when they analyze anything, they always analyze very deeply.
他眼睛看得很远。
And they see very far.
所以别人认为没有什么的，他认为问题很严重。
And so even though people might think that this is not a great problem, but yet to that person, it's a very huge problem.
能力有限，所以很多困难他不能解决。
But yet because his abilities are limited, then he feels that there are many problems he cannot solve.
越有智慧、知识越丰富的人，忧伤愁烦就更多。
So the more wisdom and knowledge a person has, then the more grief and sorrow they have.
有些一些困难不能解决。
Because there are difficulties they cannot solve.
就跳楼自杀。
And so then there are some who actually commit suicide.
自杀的人多数聪明人。
And the people that commit suicide are all very wise.
傻瓜不会自杀。
And a foolish person will not commit suicide.
你听说过傻瓜自杀吗？
Have you ever heard that someone who is foolish would actually commit suicide?
他脑筋简单啊。
Because they're very simple-minded.
他认为每件事情都没什么。
And they think that everything is just okay.
他怎么可能自杀呢？
Then why would they commit suicide?
所以自杀的都是聪明人。
And those who commit suicide are all very wise.
那自杀有没有解决问题呢？
And so when they commit suicide, have they solved the problem?
到死为止没有解决。
And even to their death, they're not able to solve the
problem. 那一种逃避。
But rather it's an escape.
逃避现实。
And it's to escape reality.
因为他不能解脱目前的困难。
Because they are not able to break past the problem in front of them.
所以所罗门说，知识增加，智慧提升，愁烦就增加。
And this is why Solomon tells us that in much wisdom and in much knowledge is grief and sorrow.
有人说，如果赚很多钱。
And then there are others who says that if I can earn a lot of money,
要买什么就可以买什么。
Then I can buy whatever I want to buy.
就得到满足快乐。
Then of course I will be satisfied and be very happy.
但所罗门说，你赚很多钱也是虚空。
But yet Solomon says that even if you gain a lot of wealth, it's still vanities.
看传道书第五章。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 5.
第十五节。
Verse 10.
传道书五章的第十五节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 10.
贪爱银子的不因得银子知足，贪爱丰富的也不因得利益知足，这也是虚空啊！这里说，贪爱金银的不能得到金银就满足。
And here it says that he who loves silver will not be satisfied with silver.
是一种虚空。
But rather is a vanity.
因为我们的内心是虚空。
Because in our inner hearts is still vanities.
心灵也是虚空。
And in the spirit is also vanity.
用虚空的东西来填满里面虚空，永远是虚空。
And as long as you continue to try to supplement the vanity with vanity, it's always going to be vanity.
人的欲望无限。
And our desires, they're limitless.
你生活很困难时候。
And then when you have difficulties in your life,
你主求出的饱就满意。
Then as long as you have something that's enough to eat, then you will be very satisfied.
等到你出的饱，你就想出更好东西。
But when you are filled with your stomach, then you just want to eat better things.
你没有衣服穿说，主要有衣服穿就满意。
If you had no clothes to wear, then you think that if I only had clothes to wear, I would be satisfied.
你有衣服穿，你又就想穿得更漂亮。
But then once you have clothes to wear, then you want to wear even better looking clothes.
你没有房子时候想有房子就满意。
And if you did not have a house, then you think, as long as I have a house, I'll be satisfied.
那你有房子以后就想有更大的房子。
But once you have that house, then you want a bigger house.
没有车子时候你想有二手的货就可二手车就可以。
And then when you don't have a car, you think, as long as I have a second-hand car, then I'll be satisfied.
你有了二手的车以后你就想买豪华汽车。
But then once you have that second-hand car, then you want to buy an even better car.
每一件事情你得到了，你的满足是短暂的时间。
And everything that we receive, our satisfaction in that is very limited.
没有多久，你的欲望又扩大。
Because not long later, then our desires will increase.
但能力有限呐。
But then our abilities are limited.
欲望是无限。
And yet our desires are unlimited.
用无限的欲望要来用满有限的能力要来满足欲望。无限的欲望是不可能。
And it's impossible to use our limited abilities to try to fulfill an unlimited desire.
所以虽然得到金银也不能满足。
And so even though we may have the gold and silver, but yet we are not satisfied.
你已经很有钱了。
And you may be very richer.
但你看看有人比你更有钱。
But then you'll see that there is someone else richer than you.
比较起来你还算穷人。
And compared to them, then you're still a poor person.
所以不管你有多大财富你都感觉还不够。
And so no matter how much wealth you have, that you still feel that it's not enough.
第十一节。
And verse 11.
货物增添，出的人也增添，物主得什么益处呢？不过是眼看而已啊！你做很大的生意。
And then if you were to have a very big business.
你的店很大，有很多货物。
And you have a big store and you have a lot of merchandise.
但出的人也增加了。
But yet the people that eat of them will increase.
因为你事业做这么大，需要雇很多工人。
Because once you have established your business so big, then you have to also have many employees.
你要工钱给他。
And you have to pay their wages.
他有饭吃。
And then so that they can have
things to eat. 所以说货物增添，出饭人也更多了。
And so even though you might have more things, but yet you also increase the number of
eat. 那老板得什么东西呢？
And what profit is it to the owners?
满足眼睛的欲望。
Except to see them with their eyes.
他用眼睛看见。
When you see it with your eyes.
这么大的店是我的。
That this big store is mine.
这么多的货物是我的。
That all this merchandise is mine.
这么多工人是看我吃饭的。
And all these employees are seeing me eat.
你虽然三餐桌子上很丰盛，摆了很多的菜。
And even if for all three meals you place a lot of food on the table.
你每天出一点点就饱了。
But you can only eat a little of each and you will be filled.
你不可能把桌上东西全部吃下去，你肚子都破裂了。
And you're not able to eat all the things on the table because then your stomach will burst.
你有好多衣服。
And you have many clothes.
你不可能现在出门穿一件新的，走一趟回来又穿一件新的，每一趟出去回来又穿一件新的出去走动。
And you're not able to just wear one new clothes every time you step out the door, and then on the next trip you wear another new clothes.
如果你真的这么做，有认识人看到你会说神经病。
And if you truly do so, then people who see you will call you crazy.
那你身体的利用价值是什么？
And then what exactly is your value in life?
活动溢价。
That you are a moving, you're a living clothes hanger.
你身体变成挂衣架的。挂衣服的衣架。
And then all you are is just a clothes hanger.
只是会活动，活动而已。活动而已，会活动啊。
And it's only that you can move back and forth.
那有什么利用价值呢？
And what kind of...
你有好大的房，
what good is that?
好大的房子。
Or if you have a big house.
有好多房间。
And you have... you have many rooms.
你十点钟去睡一个房间。
At 10 p.m. you go and sleep in one room.
点再搬一个房间。
At midnight you go and move to another room.
两点钟再搬一个房间。
At 2 a.m. you move to another room.
一直到天亮，每两个小时换一个新的房间。
And every 2 hours until the daylight, then you keep changing rooms.
因为这都是我的，都是我的。
Because it's all mine.
我有权利每个房间都睡一点点时间呢。
And I have the power to be able to sleep a little bit of time in every room.
那你整个晚上不能睡觉了。
Then the entire night you're not sleeping.
你有那么大的房子，有那么多的房间，你的主卧房一间而已。
And even though you may have many rooms in your house, but yet you can only have one master bedroom.
其他是眼睛看一看。
And then the others you can only see with your eyes.
满足眼睛欲望。
And all you are satisfying is the desires of your eyes.
三餐出的有限。
And the 3 meals you can only eat
the limited
穿的有限
amount.
And what you wear is limited.
住的有限
And where you can stay is
limited. 你有那么多东西就眼睛看而已
And so if you have more things, then it's only for your eyes.
啊，再看下面
And let's continue reading.
第十二节
Verse 12.
劳碌的人不计吃多吃少，睡得香甜，富足人的丰盛丰满，却不容他睡觉。这里说劳碌人很容易就睡觉。
And here it says that the laboring man is easy to sleep.
他不会患失眠症。
Because they won't have insomnia.
因为他动手脚不动脑筋。
Because they've been moving their hands and feet and not their minds.
脑筋不会疲劳过度。
And so their minds are not going to be overly tired.
没有愁烦。
And they don't have the worries.
容易睡觉。
And it's easy for them to sleep.
那有钱人的丰满不容他睡觉。
But then the abundance of the rich will not permit him to sleep.
因为有钱人思维很大。
Because of the rich man, they have a lot of things.
他常常在盘算怎么经营他的事业。
And then they have a lot of, they're always thinking how they can increase their business.
他的心灵压力太重。
And then they are always having too much pressure on their heart.
常常睡不着。
And so oftentimes they cannot sleep.
台湾有一个有钱人。
And in Taiwan there is a rich person.
他有很多土地。
And he has much land.
他晚上睡那个弹簧床，常常睡不着。
And then he's sleeping on the spring beds and he cannot fall asleep.
他一天一餐吃一碗就饱了。
And then when he is at each meal, he can only just eat one bowl of rice.
他雇一个工人替他种田。
And then he has a servant that actually cultivates his gardens.
中午吃过午餐要休息时候。
And then at lunchtime when he eats and he rests.
把那个耕地用的锄头放在田角。
And then he takes the plow at the corner.
那躺在那边就睡觉。
And then he just falls asleep there and he sleeps.
每餐吃完，这个工人吃五碗才吃饱。
And then every meal that he eats, and this gardener has to eat 5 bowls.
有一天，这个老板问他的工人。
And so one day, then this master of the house asked this servant.
是你当老板还是我当老板？我搞不清楚。
And he said to this gardener, I'm not sure who is the master of this house.
我一餐一碗就饱，你一餐吃五碗。
Because in every meal, then I only eat 1 bowl of rice, and yet you're eating 5.
你吃的比我更多啊。
Because you're eating more than I am.
我弹簧床睡不好，你锄头放在田角，一躺下马上睡觉。
And then for you, and then for me, I cannot sleep well on my nice bed, but yet you can just sleep in any corner.
啊，你睡得比我更多啊。
And you sleep a lot more than I do.
那我老板是名义上的老板，其实你睡得比我多，你出得比我多。
And actually, I'm only a master in name, but rather you're the one that eats and sleeps more than I do.
圣经中劳力的人睡得很香甜。
And that's why the Bible tells us that the sleep of the laboring man is sweet.
有钱人睡不着。
And the rich, they do not sleep well.
劳力的人从来不会患失眠症。
And the ones who have been laboring, they will not have insomnia.
失眠症都是有钱人。
And the insomnia always comes to those who are rich.
有学问，有地位。
Or those who are well educated or have status.
感觉上生活压力很重。
Because they feel the pressures of life.
所以就睡不着。
And so they cannot sleep.
啊，这样有钱有什么用呢？
And so what is the use of having all this money?
有钱一定比穷人更幸福吗？
And then is it better and more blessed to be rich than to be poor?
传道书第二章。
Let's look at Ecclesiastes chapter 2.
第十节。
Verse 10.
传道书二章第十节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 2 verse 10.
凡我眼睛所求的，我没有留下不给他的。我心所乐的，我没有禁足不享受的，因为我心为我一切所劳碌的快乐啊，这就是我从劳碌中所得的份。十一节。
11.
后来我查看我所经营一切事， 和我劳碌所得成的功，谁知道是虚空是捕风，在入缸柱下毫无益处。所罗门作王，
and King Solomon was king，
地位很高，
and he had a very high
status， 国家很强盛，
and his kingdom was very strong，
又有诸位学问，
and he also had a lot of education，
有钱能够享受，
and he had the money so that he can enjoy himself，
有诸位懂得怎么享受，
and then he had the wisdom to know how to enjoy himself，
有人有钱不懂怎么享受，
because there are people who have money but yet they do not know how to enjoy，
有人懂得享受没有钱享受，
and some they know how to enjoy but yet they do not have the money
to enjoy， 该有都有。
But then Solomon had what, everything.
他有钱，
and he had the money.
有享受的能力，
and he had the ability to enjoy.
他有智慧，
and he had wisdom.
懂得怎么享受，
and he knew how to enjoy himself.
所以他说，眼睛看见，心所要，多拿来享受。
And so he said that whatever his eyes desired and whatever his heart wanted, then he did not withhold from them.
年轻的时候，
and when they're young,
他以为这一辈子很幸福。
He thought that he was very blessed in his life.
活得很满意。
And he was very satisfied
in his life. 等到年老时候，
but when he got older,
他回头看一生走的路，
and he looked back on the life that he had walked,
才晓得这一切都是虚空。
Then he knew that all this was vanity.
因为年纪大了以后，
because after he got older,
欲望比较降低了，
and then his desires had lessened.
社会经历比较多了，
and then after he had more experience in life,
也比较冷静，懂得怎么思考了。
And he also was more calm and he knew how to think.
才发现这一切都是虚空。
That's when he realized that all was vanity.
没有多少意义。
And it did not have any kind of profit.
到最后呢，人就死掉了。
Because at the end, then man just dies.
你出生说什么都没有带来。
And then when you were born, you did not bring anything into this world.
每个人出生都是没有穿衣服出生的。
And everyone, when they were born, they did not wear anything.
我的太太生六个孩子。
And my wife had six children.
如果我的孩子有一个穿衣服出生，我太太吓坏了。
And if any one of them was born with clothing, my wife would have been scared to death.
啊，每个人出生都没有穿衣服啊。
And everyone, when they're born, they do not wear any clothing.
女生有衣服穿。
And then we have clothes to wear now.
你有饭吃。
And we have food to eat.
你有房子住。
And we have a house to live
in. 你有钱用。
We have money to use.
都不是出生所带来。
All these are not from when we were born.
因为你空手来到世界。
Because we came to this world empty-handed.
所以你要走，说什么都不能带走。
And so when we leave, we also cannot bring anything with us.
人生由零开始，由零结束。
And in life, we begin with a zero and we end with a zero.
哦，我们看传道书的第五章。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 5.
十五节。
Verse 15.
传道书的第五章十五节
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 15，
他怎样从母胎出生而来，也必照样出生而去，他所劳碌得来的，手中分毫不能带去。啊，每个人都是从母亲出生来到世界。
And everyone is born of their mother into this world.
然后空手离开这个世界。
And they also leave this world empty-handed.
去年台湾最有钱的一个企业家王永庆先生离世。
And last year there was a very famous person in Taiwan.
哎，他的财产有台币几百亿。
And he has several million Taiwanese dollars.
啊，我来这里的几天前，媒体报道他已经死了一年了。
And then before I left to the U.S., then they recorded that this Mr. Wang had died
for more than 1 year. 他死的时候，那个墓地很大。
And when he died, then this memorial service.
而且找最好的风水。
The plot that they buried him in is very big, and they also found the best scenery. And then they also built very
beautiful. 只有那个墓地超过了台币一亿多。
And then just for that one plot of land and the monument, it was more than $10 million.
但是他什么都不知道。
But he did not know any of this.
他空手离开这个世界。
Because he had left this world empty-handed.
什么都不能带走。
And he cannot bring anything with him.
人生难道这样就过一辈子吗？
And is this just life?
这样有什么价值，有什么意义呢？
And what is the actual meaning of this? And what's the purpose?
所罗门从传道书一章开始说什么都虚空。
And from the very beginning of Ecclesiastes in chapter 1, he says that vanity is vanity.
很多主力家都说人生虚空。
And then there are also many philosophers that says that life is vanity.
但他们不懂怎么去解决这个问题。
But yet they do not know how to solve this problem.
所罗门不但给我们看见人生一切虚空。
But yet Solomon not only lets us see that all is vanity.
更宝贵的是他告诉我们怎么样才不虚空。
What's even more precious is that he tells us how is it that it would not be vanity.
怎么样才能够脱离虚空的人生，进入充足的人生。
And how is it that we can leave a life of vanity to have a life of substance?
我们看传道书十二章。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 12.
十三节。
Verse 13.
传道书的十二章十三节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13.
这些都是听已经听见了，总意就是敬畏神，谨守他的诫命，这是人所当尽的本分啊。在这里说。这些事已经听见，就是说，从一章到十二章，我已经讲太多了。
And so he says, let us hear the whole matter, the conclusion of the whole matter, which means that he has already spoken everything and too much.
就是说，人生一切都是虚空。
First 11 chapters, which is to say that life is vanity.
那么怎么样才不虚空呢？
So how is it that it is not vanity?
总意叫做敬畏神。
And the conclusion is to fear God.
总意就是说，总说一句话，我的结论是什么？
And the conclusion is, and so this is actually his conclusion.
要敬畏神。
That we have to fear God.
守他的诫命。
And to keep his commandments.
这是人当尽的本分。
And this is the work, this is what man should do.
如果你这样，你就不虚空。
And if we do this, then it is not vanity.
这里提两件事情。
And here it talks about two things.
第一件就是敬畏神。
And the first is that we fear God.
第二件守他的诫命。
And the second is to keep his commandments.
这个是人当尽的本分。
And this is what man ought to do.
每个人都有他当尽的本分。
And every person has what they ought to do.
如果你懂得自己是什么本分，而且努力去尽你的本分。
And if you know what your responsibility is and you do it.
你是一个有价值的人。
Then you are a person that has value.
如果你不懂自己该尽什么本分。
But then if you do not know what effort you should be putting forth.
那你的人生是没有多少意义价值的。
Then your life does not have much value.
那所罗门在这说，我们要尽的本分的第一项就是敬畏神。
And so here Solomon says that our efforts have, the first thing we must do is to fear God.
我们每个人都父母所生。
And we are all born of our parents.
是我们养大。
And they raise us.
给我们恩惠很高。
And then they have also paid a lot of price for us.
比山更高，比海更深。
And then it's more and higher than the mountains and deeper than the sea.
孝顺父母是儿女的本分。
And so it's our responsibility to respect our parents.
一个人如果不懂孝顺父母，他是没有尽本分的人，是一个没有价值的人。
And if a person does not know how to honor their parents, then this person has not put forth their efforts, and this is a person that has no worth.
那父母也有他的父母。
And then each parent has their own parents.
我们一直往上追，都达到我们最早的一个父母。
And then if we were to continue going up this ladder, then we come up to the very first father.
就神所造的。
Which is the one that God has created.
所以神是我们历代祖宗的源头。
And so God is actually the origin of our ancestors of mankind.
也是我们父母的源头。
And it's also the origin of our parents.
所以孝顺父母是我们做儿女的本分。
And to honor our parents is the responsibility of the children.
敬拜天的神是我们每个人当尽的本分。
And likewise, to worship God is also our responsibility.
因为有神创造他我们的历代的祖宗。
And because God had created our very first ancestors.
还有我们个人的存在。
And also each of our existence.
我们人要活着。
And for each one of us to be living,
维持生命,
to maintain our lives,
有几个不可缺少条件,
then there are several requirements.
要有空气,
because we must have air,
要有阳光,
and we must have sunlight,
要喝的水,
we must have water to drink,
要出的东西,
and things to eat,
还有空气,
and air,
啊, 太阳, 空气,
and the sun and the air,
水,
and water,
食物,
and the food.
这些东西少一件不能生活,
and without one of these, then we cannot live.
那这些都是神创造的。
And all these things are created by God.
生命就从神来。
And life comes from God.
维持生命的东西也是神给的。
And then to maintain all this God's...
维持生命的东西是神给的。
And then to be able to maintain God's things is also given by God.
神的恩惠比我们父母更多。
And God, what God has given to us is even more than what our parents has given.
敬畏神是我们当尽的本分。
And so to fear God is our basic responsibility.
第二个本分呢,
and what is the second?
守他的诫命,
that we must keep his commands.
除了孝敬的以外,
and just like as children to our parents, and not only do we must we honor them, but we must obey them.
儿女听父母的教训,
and if a child were to listen to the parents, then the parents would be very satisfied. And this person will also be very respected by the society.
大家就会说,这个父母很会教这个儿女这么善良。
And everyone will say that the parents really know how to teach this child to be good.
父母就得到荣耀。
And the parents will be glorified.
这个是孝顺父母一个表达方式。
And so this is one manifestation of how we honor our parents.
我们是神所创造的。
And we are created by God.
我们又得到神赐的空气、阳光、水跟食物，维持生命。
And that we have also received the sunlight, air, and water, and food to sustain our lives from God.
所以我们应当敬拜神。
And so we must worship God.
也应当守他的教训。
And we also have to keep his commandments.
神的教训是什么？
And what are his commandments?
就要爱神，爱人好像爱自己。
Which is that we have to love man as ourselves.
今天世界缺少爱。
And today the world is lacking in love.
因为缺少爱, 所以有这个人与人之间的斗争。
And because there is a lack of love, then there are all these different wars.
还有很多的罪恶。
And there are a lot of sins.
为了得到主的益处, 伤害别人。
And in order for us to receive our own benefits, then we may harm others.
很多人感觉这个世界很黑暗。
And so there are people that feel that this earth is very dark.
但如果每个人都敬拜神,
but then if everyone worshiped God,
守他的教训,
and kept his commandments,
他不会伤害别人,
then they will not hurt others.
他会爱别人好像爱自己。
And so then if we love ourselves, and love others as ourselves,
就有温暖。
Then this society will have warmth.
那么一个家庭里面多信耶稣,
and in a family, if everyone believes in Jesus, and they all worship God,
父母用神的话教训儿女,
and the parents use the word of God to teach the children,
儿女懂得孝顺父母,
and the children also knows how to respect the parents,
丈夫懂得爱妻子,
and then the husband knows how to love the wife,
妻子懂得尊敬她的丈夫,
and the wife knows how to respect the husband,
那么这个家就很圆满,
and then this family will be very
就很幸福,
perfect, and they're very blessed.
家庭幸福不就因为你有钱, 大家都过得很幸福。
And the family is not blessed because you're very rich, and so everybody can live well.
圣经有一句话说,
and the Bible tells us,
吃素菜, 大家和睦相处,
and that if we ate vegetables and everyone dwells happily together,
胜过出牛, 大家相争嫉妒,
it's better than to eat the meat and then also dwell in strife.
出牛肉表示这个家有钱,
and if they eat the beef, then it means that this family has wealth.
全家不圆满, 出的也不快乐。
But yet the family is not very happy, and they're not perfect.
吃素菜素这个家没有钱买鱼买肉,
and if they were to eat vegetables, then this means that this family does not have the money to buy the fish or meat. But yet the family loves one another.
这才是真正幸福。
And this is a true blessing.
所以幸福不是建立在财富的上面。
And so the blessing is not built upon wealth.
建在彼此相爱这个基础的上面。
But rather it's built on the foundation of loving one another.
现在说神就爱。
And the Bible tells us that God is love.
你如果信的这一位神,
and if we believe in this God,
你心中有神的爱,
and in our hearts, and there is this love.
你把这爱带到家里面来,
and then you bring this love into your house.
这个家里的每个人都能够彼此相爱,
and then everyone in the home can love one another.
然后你就把这爱带到社会去,
and then you bring this love to the society.
爱别人好像爱自己,
and you love others like yourself.
我们的家好像天堂,
and then our house is like heaven.
我们世界也好像天堂,
and then our world is also like heaven.
就在地上如同在天上,
and then it will be like heaven on earth.
我们会感觉活得很快乐,
and then we will feel that we're living very joyfully.
我们也活得很有意义,
and then we also live with purpose.
所以圣经才说,
and that's why the Bible tells us,
最大宝贝是耶稣,
that the greatest treasure is Jesus Christ.
如果你没有耶稣,
because if we do not have Jesus,
你有钱,
but you have money,
有地位,
you have status,
有学问,
or have education,
有很高物质享受,
and have a lot of things to enjoy,
你并不觉得真正喜乐跟平安,
but yet you will not feel the true joy and peace.
如果你没有钱,
but if you do not have money,
没有地位,
and no status,
没有很高学问,
and not a lot of education,
但你有耶稣,
but yet you have Jesus,
你也会充满喜乐跟平安,
then you will be filled with joy and peace.
耶稣才是最大的宝贝,
because Jesus Christ is the greatest treasure.
看腓立比书第三章,
let's turn to Philippians chapter 3,
第八节,
verse 8.
腓立比书的第三章, 第八节。
Philippians chapter 3 verse 8。
腓立比书三章八节。
Philippians chapter 3 verse 8。
不但如此，我也将万事当作有损的，因为我已认识我主基督耶稣为至宝。我为他已经丢弃万事，看作粪土，为要得着基督。保罗信耶稣以后。
And after Paul believed in Jesus Christ, 他的价值观完全改变。He changed his value system.
他说以前我认为很宝贵的东西，现在把它当作粪土。
And the things that he saw as very good before, he now counts them as loss, as rubbish.
把耶稣当作最大的宝贝。
And then he sees Jesus Christ as his greatest treasure.
台湾教有一个信徒。
And there is a member in Taiwan.
他做很大事业。
And he had a very huge, successful business.
赚了不少的钱。
And he earned a lot of money.
有一次他告诉我。
And one time he told me,
他的腓立比三章八节这样的话，他看好几次不了解。
And he said that I had read Philippians chapter 3 verse 8 many times and I did not understand.
他说我的太太跟我感情很好。
He says that my wife has a very good relationship with me.
我怎么可能把她当作粪土呢？
And how is it that I can see her as rubbish?
我的儿女每个都很可爱。
And my children are all very adorable.
我怎么会把儿女当作粪土呢？
How is it that I would see my children as rubbish?
我的事业是几十年辛苦去建立起来的。
And my business was one that I established over decades.
它很宝贵啊。
And it's very precious.
我怎么能把它当作粪土呢？
So how can I see this as rubbish?
我说东西的价值是比较问题。
I said the value of things is all a relative.
如果没有拿耶稣比较。
And if there is nothing to compare.
你的太太。
If there's not Jesus Christ to compare, then the
你的事业
then your wife and your
都非常宝贵
then your wife and your children and your career are all very
都不是粪土
precious and then they are not rubbish.
如果那也就做比较
but if you take Jesus Christ as a comparison,
它就变成粪土
then it becomes rubbish.
因为耶稣价值无限
because Jesus has an infinite value.
人认为宝贵东西都是有限的
but what man values all has limit.
用有限的东西来比较无限的东西，它就不成比例啊。
And then when you take something of value to compare with the infinite value, then it becomes nothing.
有时候晚上停电
，and sometimes if the electricity goes out at
night, 房间很暗
，and it becomes very dark.
你点一根蜡烛
，and if you just light one candle,
就感觉很亮。
And it feels very bright.
因为没有别的光线做比较。
Because there are no other light to compare.
就一根蜡烛的光度才一瓦特而已。
And now it said that the light of the candle is only one watt.
你就感觉很亮啊。
And yet you feel it's very bright.
如果说白天。
But yet if it's light outside.
中午太阳很大时候。
And it's in the noontime when the sun
is very
bright. 你
在太阳下点一根蜡烛。
And then you light up this candle under the sun.
世界并没有更光明。
And the world has not become brighter.
你把它吹熄了。
And if you were to extinguish this candle.
世界没有更暗。
This world has not diminished in brightness because the sunlight is much brighter.
用很强的太阳光来比较那一根箭珠有跟没有没有差别。
And so when you compare the sunlight with whether or not you have this candle,
所以没有耶稣做比较。
And likewise, if you do not have Jesus as a
comparison, 我们所认为的妻子、丈夫或者儿女
，then our wife and our children and or our career,
或是这个你的事业。
Or our jobs,
或是你的地位
or our status,
或是你的学问
or our education,
每一样都很宝贵
everything is very precious,
没有一样是粪土
and there's nothing that's rubbish,
但是用耶稣来比较它变成粪土
but then when you compare them with Jesus Christ and they become rubbish,
耶稣价值无限
because Jesus has infinite value,
不能做比较的
and you cannot make a comparison,
如果你信耶稣
and if you believe in
Jesus
Christ,
你的生命改变
And your life changes.
你的价值观马上改变。
Your values will also change.
你才会真的了解什么才是宝贝。
And then you will know what is the true value.
你就会充满喜乐跟平安。
And then you will be filled with peace and joy.
保罗以前没有信耶稣。
And before Paul believed in Jesus.
他到处抓信耶稣的人去定罪。
And he went and persecuted all the Christians.
后来信了耶稣。
And later on he believed in Jesus.
为了传耶稣，到处受逼迫、被鞭打、坐牢。
And then in order for him to preach Jesus Christ, then he was persecuted, and he was whipped, and he was also thrown to prison.
最后被判死刑。
And at the very end, then he was sentenced to death.
但他还就充满喜乐。
And yet he was still filled with joy.
因他已经得到最大的宝贝。
Because he had already received the greatest treasure.
台湾有两个传道。
And in Taiwan, there is a preacher.
以前当医生。
Before he was a doctor.
后来不当医生当传道。
And later on, he was no longer a doctor, but rather a preacher.
当医生赚的钱比传道更多啊。
And then the money that he had made up to that point was more than he ever made as a preacher.
但他认为当传道对人的帮助更大。
But then he felt that to be a preacher has more help to mankind.
医生只能医好人身体的病。
Because a doctor can only heal the physical ailments of man.
当传道神传扬神的话。
But then a preacher, when they're preaching the word of God,
可以医治人心灵的病,
they can heal the hearts of man.
对人的帮助更大,
and this is a greater help to man.
所以他不当医生, 当传道。
And so he no longer was a doctor, but he became a preacher.
啊, 也有人读到了博士。
And there were others who had received a PhD.
台湾有一个。
And in Taiwan there is one.
美国教有一个。
And in Taiwan church, there's, in the US there's also one.
读到博士来读神学院。
That they already have a PhD, and then they come to study the theological seminary.
他认为当传道传神的话来改变美国人的一生。
And they feel that in order for them to preach the word of God, and then to affect lives of man.
给美国人的生命更新。
And to give people the renewal of their lives.
给美国人得到真的喜乐平安。
And to give people true joy and peace.
给美国家庭活得更圆满。
And so that every household can live more perfectly.
他认为这个价值更高。
And so he thinks that this value is even greater.
啊，我以前在小学当教员。
And I was actually a teacher in an elementary school.
当然，小学教员没有什么所、mm-hmm. 没有什么身份可言呐、啊。
And of course, there is no status to speak of for the elementary school teachers.
啊，但主耶稣选召我以后，我就开始当传道。
But after Jesus Christ chose me, then I came out to be a preacher.
啊，我认为在小学当教员会造就很多的这个人才，没有错。
And then I felt that I could edify many people and help their characteristics.
因为美国大人物多，经过小学，然后才读中学，读大学拿到学位的。
Because as a teacher, then everyone has to go through elementary school before they can go on to further education.
小学一个基础啊。
And so elementary school is a foundation.
基础做得好，他就无限的前途。
And then if you were to establish the foundation well, then you can give them unlimited potential.
所以当小学教员这个工作也是很有价值。
And so to me, the value of being a childhood educator is very important.
但当传道价值更高。
But yet to be a preacher, the value is even better.
因为有些家庭已经破碎了。
Because there are some families that are already broken.
他没有基督的爱在里面。
And they do not have the love of Christ in them.
但传道人把神的话传给他。
And then when the preacher preaches the word of God to them.
这个家庭接受主的救恩。
And then this family receives the salvation of Christ.
他的家就充满喜乐跟平安。
And then their family will be filled with peace and joy.
所以圣经说传福音的人脚中何等佳美。
And that's why the Bible says, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel.
因为他会给每个人带来真的喜乐平安。
Because they will bring true joy and peace to everyone.
而且会把他带到神面前，得到永远的福气。
And they will also bring people before the Lord to give them eternal blessings.
啊，晚上我就到这里告一段落。
And so this, it can, when you
明天下午还有明天晚上还有布道会。
And tomorrow afternoon and also evening we have evangelical services.
你今天晚上来，明天下午不来，你会后悔一辈子。
And if you come tonight but you do not come tomorrow afternoon, then you will be regretting this for the rest of your life.
因为明天讲的更宝贵。
Because tomorrow is even more precious.
今天是开场白，讲一点点而已。
And today is just an introduction, so we only speak a little bit.
明天下午跟明天晚上啊，会更深入的探讨这个问题。
And so tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening, we will look at this issue even more in depth.
啊，所以你明天一定要来。
And so tomorrow you must come.
还要把你的家里人、你的朋友都带来。
And you must also bring your family members and also your friends.
啊，给他们一起分享你所得到的主的恩典。
And so that they can also receive the blessings that you have received.
唱诗。
Let's all sing hymn.
103首。
103.